Welcome back to Body Beautiful. With us today, we have plastic surgeon Dr. Joseph Mele, and we're talking about breast augmentation and revision. We'll also be taking your calls, answering any questions you might have for the doctor. Here's the phone number, 415-561-8753. We'll also be posting the phone number to the doctor's office, so be ready to jot that down. And before we get started, any advice we give you today, you'll also want a second opinion. Consult your own physician as well. Well, doctor, we were talking a little bit about, you know, say somebody comes in with a magazine and they say a picture of a star that they happen to want to look like, and they bring it to you and say, I want breasts just like XYZ.
Sure. And in some ways, it's really helpful because it helps me know kind of what range, what size they're looking for in terms of how it relates to the person they're showing me body. But it's not going to be the same because every body's a little bit different. Everybody has a little bit different shape. But the proportion does help. So if I see someone, they want Carmen Electra's breast, she's larger than average size for her frame. And that means to me, you know, that's where they want to be. And it's something I need to talk about. It's not that we shouldn't go there if it's too big, or we shouldn't go there if it's too small. It's just we need to know what the risks and the benefits are and make sure that they're going to be happy in the end.
Well, people also have to be reminded that those photographs in those fashion magazines and tabloids, I mean, those
folks are chosen because they look spectacular.
Right.
So they're starting above average, to say the least. And then on some of the photographs, some artists may spend 8-10 hours airbrushing it to change the way that it looks. So yeah, there has to be realistic expectations.
Yeah.
And I do get a little worried when someone comes in and says, you know, I want to look exactly like so-and-so, because really as plastic surgeons, we don't have the ability to completely change the way someone looks. We can enhance what's there, we can get things into balance, but we can't, you know, take you and make you look like Brad Pitt. Not that you would want to. He's a good-looking guy, but there are certain parts of the bone, the structures, the skin, the fat that we really don't want to mess with, that we want to leave alone, but we can enhance the features of there, get them into proportion.
Okay. Well, you brought some photographs and we talked about showing them, so let's go ahead and jump right into it. Let's start with the first one here. Walk me through it.
So this is a standard sort of breast augmentation of someone with normal shaped breasts, but has some deflation. The upper pole is kind of empty. There's a little indentation now next to the arm, and the nipples sit a little bit low on the breast. On the left side, that's the before. On the right side, that's afterwards. So you can see everything looks larger, but also the nipple looks like it's been lifted.
Mm-hmm.
It hasn't. The nipple was in the right place. We've just enhanced the size and given it some support.
So she actually looks like the same, except just a little rounder and fuller, right?
Exactly. Implants really just augment what's there. So they enlarge whatever's there.
Yeah, the way nature intended, right?
Yeah.
You're just helping nature along a little bit. Okay.
And now the rest, I think most of these others are revision. So this is someone, you can see there's some asymmetry. Her right breast on the left picture is before, her right breast is lower than the left, and it's kind of bottomed out. And either an implant can just be put in too low, or more commonly, the attachments on the ribs will loosen up a little bit more on one side and the other. And if it's a larger implant, it's more likely to push down with time.
Mm-hmm.
So in this case, what's happened is I've gone back in and reformed that inframammary fold, that nice curve that's underneath the breast. I've had to sort of make it anew and attach things back where they were supposed to go.
Okay.
And that lifts the implant back up.
And this picture here?
Similar here. This is the opposite problem. This is capsular contracture. So if an implant has a normal scar on it and that scar becomes tight, mm-hmm. it may push the implant up or to the outside or shift it. And in this case, it's pushed the implant up, and that side, if you were to touch that breast, it would feel harder because the capsule is squeezing the implant. So here what I've done is release that capsule to soften things up, and either it can be treated with a capsulotomy, which just means to open that scar up, mm-hmm. or a capsulectomy, where you actually remove some of that scar if it's real thick.
Wait, how common is something like that, the capsular contracture?
Capsular contracture, deflation, and just the plain desire to change implants are probably the most common reasons that we go back, each of them accounting for about a third of the most common times going back.
Okay, and this last picture here?
And similar here, this is even more extreme contracture. And the problem becomes, not only does it look asymmetric with the clothes off, it looks asymmetric with clothes on.
Yeah.
So even through a t-shirt that's tight, you're gonna see this. If anything that's got any sort of V in the neck, the right breast is too high. But it's fixable.
Uh-huh.
You know, it's something that we have to go in and fix once in a while. And I think that's the important part is, if this happens, if you're a patient who has capsular contracture, you don't have to feel like, oh, it's the end of the world, or why me? It does happen. It happens fairly frequently, but it is something we can usually correct.
Is that a complex surgical procedure, or is that fairly routine?
The procedure itself is fairly simple.
Mm-hmm.
It is done in a surgery center because we want to keep the implant sterile, so I wouldn't try this in the office. But it's a fairly straightforward procedure. The unpredictable part is capsular contracture. We're not sure exactly what causes it. We know some things that'll slow it down.
And so this is sort of similar. We actually have another couple of pictures here. What's happening?
This is someone where the cleavage is asymmetric. So the blue line is the middle. And you can see the right breast is sort of out to the side more. The left breast is more to the middle. And the left breast is actually a little bit too close to the middle. So what I've done is reform the curve on the inside on the left. Where that asterisk is, there's some wrinkles. It's a little harder to see on the screen, but you can actually see wrinkles in her implant in that area, which is a place we really don't want wrinkles.
No.
Most commonly, they're on the outside where we don't see them. Sometimes we'll feel them and not see them. But when we see them in the middle, it's not attractive. So in this case, I've modified the capsule, actually increased the thickness of the capsule inside on the left, and then move the right implant over.
Oh my goodness, okay. So,
and this is more severe bottoming out.
Right.
So these are implants that are large. They're anything over about 350 cc's is considered a larger implant. These are closer to 500 plus. And the implants have just dropped down with time. So over many years, the implant has just pushed its way down. But again, it's correctable. So what I've done is reform the fold underneath the breast on each side and brought those up. The other way to fix this is with a breast lift. And a breast lift would be important if the skin was sagging down. But that leaves a scar on the outside. This was corrected just doing the lift inside, so no additional scar.
And this is not someone who would consider maybe making them smaller and less tug on the body.
Actually, making them smaller would be a good idea in that situation because it's less likely to reform.
Okay. We need to take a quick break, but for more information about Dr. Mele, call him directly, 925-943-6353, or check him out on the web at drmele.com or on San Francisco Breast.com. And when we come back on Body Beautiful, we'll continue talking more about breast augmentation. Plus, we'll take your phone calls. Stay with us.